Hey, it's me, Q from Blurredwood, and I'm here to talk to you about my weekend at Big Lit Comic Con Nova. What is up, guys? We're back with another Artist Alley vlog. I've missed you guys. I know it's been a while. To jump right in, we didn't really make anything new except for these Naruto thermoses, which are fire. But besides that, we had probably like 2 weeks to really prepare for this con. And as you can see, we packed the car to the brim to go to Nova. So wish us luck on this adventure. So we hit the road around 5:30. It was easy for us to go early because we wanted to have more time to set up. The con didn't open until 8 a.m., but we got there around 7 a.m. So that was okay. It gave us time to go and find food for breakfast and everything else like that. I definitely, as I always preach, get to the con as early as possible. Trust me, it will help you out a lot. So once we finally pulled up to the Dulles Expo Hall, I really hope I'm saying that right, we quickly unloaded the car and got in there and tried to find our table as fast as possible, like we always do. We did have a little problem at the front desk. They did not know where our booth was and they didn't have me on the list, but that was a minor inconvenience and we quickly got that solved and they quickly gave me a booth. And here's my booth right here. Now, it didn't take us that long to bring everything to the booth and unpack it, and the setup time was pretty fast. It was like 30 minutes. So now, without any further ado, here is my booth. As I said before, the new thing that we made were these Naruto thermoses that I was really proud of. And for the rest of the booth, this was probably one of my biggest booths. They gave us a 10 by 10 table, and I was so shocked how big this table was because I was like, oh wait, I can put so much more stuff like my bentos on display. And overall, I love the booth setup. So the con doors officially opened, and yeah, this is kind of it. It kind of picked up maybe like 30 minutes later, but it wasn't really the best. I'm just going to be honest. It wasn't really the best, guys. And here's me for some more.
So it is almost 3 or at 3, and the con is not going as good. Thought it would be. There's not a lot of people here and not a lot of spenders here. So it has been kind of difficult for not spenders and artists to actually good sales. Don't know if it's going to pick up, but you'll see later on if it's going to pick up or not.
Yeah, it did not at all. But to be honest, I need to give this con a little bit of slack. It's only their third year out here. This was actually their highest attended con in the past 3 years that they've been doing this, and I mean, that's a win, so I am proud of them for that. It's just kind of wish the advertisement was a little more like their other con that's in Roanoke. I think that would have done a lot better for us as artists and the con in general. But hey, maybe next year will be a lot better. Maybe next year they'll have a lot more advertisement and have a lot more people come out. But for this con on the Saturday that I went, it was not it. I'm being honest, it definitely was not it. I barely met my goal of making my booth and hotel back on the first day. So yeah, that was kind of disappointing. But hey, it's a learning experience at the end of the day, guys.
Alright guys, it is the start of day 2, well, the last day, and pretty nervous, low-key. Yesterday was not as good as I would like it to be, but we're gonna hope that today is a lot better than day 1, so let's get it started, guys. Let's get it started. Well guys, unfortunately it is like 9:10 right now, and they still have not opened the doors for the vendors, so yeah. That's a problem, but we'll see if they open it like at 9:30 or something. for that. Well, till then, we gotta wait. Alright guys, we're in. It's 9:30. Time to go and find my booth and get it all set up.
So as soon as I got to my booth, I uncovered everything and set everything up like I usually do, make sure that I have new things restocked and make sure that everything looks nice and tidy and organized like everyone should. I definitely advise you to make sure you do like a little check to see if everything's still there, just in case, just as precautionary measures and everything. And presto, there we go. There's my booth, always looking wonderful and gorgeous as ever. Ah, I love this booth. So with that out the way, I got to actually walk around, which I can't really do a lot of the times because I'm usually vending alone, so yeah. But I got to see all these cool, amazing people that were there at the con, and I got to explore and see all the different booths and artists. And speaking of artists, I got to meet the owner of a small business called Cineco, and her artwork is amazing. And this was her first con, so like that was even better. I love seeing people who just start out in cons, and apparently she watches my YouTube videos, and she gifted me this little guy. I have named him Derek, Derek the Duck. Definitely go follow ASAP. So on Sunday, the con doors opened around 11 a.m. and that was all right. And once people were let in, you can noticeably see there was a little more people than yesterday, which is really good. I'm happy that there was a little more people yesterday. It was a little more consistent in like customers walking to your booth and checking out what you had. And I was very happy about that, but it wasn't as much as I would have liked. But for more on that, here I am.
So guys, for day two so far, it's like around 2 blocks, so I mean, it's picked up a little more than it was yesterday, so that's pretty good. Sales-wise, it's actually pretty, I'm getting more consistent sales in this week, so I'm very happy about that. I will say it is still a low turnout crowd, but I mean, it's still better than yesterday, so I guess that's a plus.
So around 3:30, 4 o'clock, the con got really slow, and that was just due to the cosplay contest going on at the time, and so a lot of artists were free because a lot of us were not making sales because everyone was at the cosplay contest, but it allowed me to go see some of my friends and, you know, visit their booth and see what they were doing. And as I was walking around, I actually bumped into a vendor that I met back at Konjutsu, Chelsea Studios. I actually have one of her prints. I have her Paldean Wooper print that I bought at Konjutsu, and I love it so much. Definitely go and check her out. She's such a nice and sweet artist. She has such good work, and she's super duper talented. As I said, go follow her. She's amazing, and I can't wait to see her at another con. So as it got closer to 5, a lot of the vendors started packing up, including me myself. I started packing up a little bit before 5 to get everything in boxes, so once we load out, we load out. But this con, it was okay. I mean, it was definitely a learning experience, and you really can't win them all. So, you know, you learn for next year, and you try to do better. But yeah, Big Lick Comic-Con Nova was definitely an experience, and I really just hope it grows. That's my main thing. I hope it grows.
It's time for the con review.
What is up, guys? We're back with your favorite part of the vlog, the con review.
This review is based off my experience at the convention. Other people might have better or worse experiences, but this one is mine.
All right, guys, let's kick it off with attendance. And as you saw in the video, the attendance was at an all-time low. Like, they did say that this is their biggest crowd, but it was not big enough, personally, for me. So we're going to give that an 8 out of 20. And for the staff, there was a lot that went wrong. The really upside was the staff was super nice. It's just a lot felt like off, like there was not enough advertisement for the con. There was that situation where they didn't open up the con early so the vendors can get in there on the second day, and then also they couldn't find my booth. So I'm gonna have to give them a 12 out of 20. I'm sorry, but hey, that's what you get. Then we get to artists and vendors, and I really didn't have too much problems with artists and vendors. They're always usually amazing and fantastic, so 20 out of 20, as always. Customers, they get a 10 out of 20. I'm sorry, like, people really weren't buying. It was one of the situations where it seemed like if it cost over 20 bucks, they're not gonna buy it, and I don't like that, but hey, it is what it is, a learning experience. And to finish it off, we are going to go with sales, which also gets a 10 out of 20. And that's just due to I didn't have consistent sales. There wasn't consistent customers at my booth for me to have consistent sales. It would be like, you know, 10 to 20 minutes between customers coming over, and that's also due to the attendance being kind of low. So, you know, customers were spread out throughout the con, and it was very thin spread. Calculating all these numbers together, it leads us to a 60, which is a D minus con. And yeah, that's not good, but you can only get better from here. I mean, it's only their third year, and they can definitely get better. I think the main thing was the advertisement, you know, trying to get more customers in there, trying to be a little more organized, but they were really nice. Like, I'm not gonna say like, oh, this, they were trash and they don't know how to run a con. No, never. They were actually really good, and they were really excited for what they did this year. You know, give a little pat on the back, but you know, there is always room for improvement, and for this con, there's definitely room for improvement at the end of the day. But yeah, will I return next year? Probably not. Not until they fix a few things and have it as the same size as their Roanoke con, which is their bigger con. But I do think that they're going to grow and they're going to get bigger. And once they do that, I definitely will check it out one more time to see how it is. And yeah, that was Big Lit Comic-Con Nova. I definitely had an interesting time. But to keep up with me, definitely hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. I appreciate you guys for coming through, and I can't wait to have another vlog for you in the future. Definitely stay tuned.
Oh, no.